Welcome back to the show, bud.
It's good. How are you doing?
I'm doing fantastic.
I'm so happy to be here.
There's a lot I have to talk to you about. Congratulations, you've directed a film.
I directed a film. I know, it's a weird thing.
It's a giant deal. Are you now in the club of directors? Do you go to work out with Martin Scorsese?
Absolutely. Marty and I are really close.
We got to get into this. I want to talk about this. First of all, you just had a big birthday. Happy 40th.
I turned 40, yeah.
That's a big deal.
Yeah, thank you.
Happy birthday.
Thank you so much.
Do you have a big party? Do you do a thing?
Are you a birthday person?
I kind of.
Neither am I.
Yeah, I was, and then I'm not really.
I do one birthday every 10 years. So I do 20, 30,
decades.
40, 50, and then whenever, you know.
Yeah.
Ends it for me.
No, you'll be going a long way. Yeah.
You know.
What do you do for 40?
I went to Italy. I brought some friends. Yeah. Listen.
I would say, ooh la la, but no, you say it like, ooh, ciao.
How about the fact that I've been to Italy a lot and can't speak a single word? It's a horrible thing.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, took some friends. We had a great couple weeks.
Oh, I love that.
You know, it's like life has been good.
Yeah.
Take your friends out. Have a good time.
Do it.
Exactly. But I don't understand the birthday thing. Some people celebrate their birthdays for like a month. Those people laughing are the people that celebrate the birthday.
They know exactly
what I'm talking about.
No, yeah, the whole month is like
it's a whole thing.
It's my birthday
by week
3,
your friends are talking about you behind your back.
So it's like get over it.
Exactly.
Yeah. No one cares.
The birthday comes, it goes.
Yeah, I want to ask you about this. Hopefully, you can answer this. If not, we can cut it out of the show.
Okay.
But there were reports going around that you were possibly going to be in the big Barbie film.
Yeah.
And that your name was on the list, and that for some reason it just didn't work out. But the lists have been floating around. Your name is.
Yeah, I know. There's a few of us on that list. And there was a moment where I would have yes.
This is true. You
yeah, and
almost
then you know Barbie. it was the pandemic, and I was working on something else, and I couldn't. It was like 3 or 4 days that we couldn't make work, and so then you know. But do you expect that list to be released to the world?
No.
It's like you were supposed to potentially have been in the biggest movie on the planet. How do you feel?
There you go.
They just got a whole SAG ensemble nomination, so I feel like peripherally that extends to myself as well.
Congratulations.
Thank you so
Congratulations
much.
Congratulations on the nomination.
No, it's good.
Something cool happened to you this summer. I saw you, actually, you didn't post this, but you met Annie Lennox.
I met Annie Lennox.
I love Annie Lennox.
I love Annie Lennox. Annie Lennox is someone that has been on mixtapes, CD tapes happened before.
No, I'll explain. We'll explain it to you.
From when I was very, very young.
Oh, I love that.
And there are people, like music I love, it's like I put playlists together before I write. It means like a ton to me. And so she was one of the greats that I never thought I would ever cross paths with. And then fate brings you together.
You met her.
And you cower in a corner and avoid the person like the plague.
Why, because you're shy?
Yeah, well, of course. I mean, who's gonna presume that Annie Lennox wants to say hi to you? That's a weird thing.
But you're damn
I don't know. That's something I have to work out in therapy, I guess.
Yeah. Well, here's what makes it even cooler.
Yeah.
You actually get up the guts to meet her.
Well, no. So I went to see Joni Mitchell at the Gorge, which was one of the great musical experiences. And I was fortunate enough to go backstage, and Brandi Carlile saw me essentially like pacing somewhere in the corner and said, just go say hello to Annie Lennox.
Yeah.
Brought me over. And I guess she had watched my show.
Yeah.
She reacted. I thought that Joni Mitchell was behind me, because who
was Annie Lennox reacting
exactly.
to?
Not certainly
Look
not
what
me.
Annie Lennox posts. She goes, Annie Lennox posted this. So this is me in heaven. The moment I met Dan Levy.
So, yeah.
He really doesn't know how much I love him.
It's wild.
Are you kidding
Apparently
me?
The show, like, comforted her during the pandemic. But I spent the entirety of our meeting screaming at her. Like, you can see it there. I was screaming at the woman.
You're holding your throat. You go,
Anyway, meet your idols, everybody. She is absolutely incredible.
She is the coolest person on earth. Congratulations.
I don't know. Life does weird things sometimes.
But you're a music guy. You've interviewed tons of artists. You used to work at MTV in Canada.
Yeah, I used to work at MTV.
Are there any artists at MTV in Canada that were, breaking? You're like, oh, yeah, I had a great interview with them before they were big.
Yeah. So I used to... in my early 20s, I spent some time in London. And when I was in London, I fell in love with a little known musician called Adele. And I know, it's, I guess she'll make it sometime.
Yeah.
And I came back to Canada, got my job. Adele was touring in Toronto at a tiny venue, like a really tiny, intimate venue. And I said to my producers, you absolutely have to get this girl on the show. We have to talk to her, and she has to perform. And my bosses at the time were like, it's not Sum 41, so no.
Wow.
And I was like, there was a rage in my eye. Like, there was a, they knew that I was like, it was early days, I could have quit. Finally, I pushed it through. She comes on the show. We interview her for 19. She performs in our studio, which is like the size of this studio.
Yeah, it's intimate.
Everyone, you could hear a pin drop. And you knew in those early days, like, she has a power that can stop a room.
Yeah, she's one of the greatest ever.
It was unbelievable.
Do you remember the story?
Well, no, I saw her in Vegas.
But Brandi Carlile wasn't with you?
Brandi Carlile wasn't with me. Although she did come over and, like, sort of grabbed my hand and gave me a wink. So I don't know. Maybe she did remember.
Yes! All right, I'll take this. She's super cool.
Did you see that Vegas show?
I haven't yet, no.
I was astral projecting. It was the most extraordinary thing.
That it might be the greatest concert
the
ever.
The scope of it. The spectacle of it. Anyway, go see it if you haven't seen it.
Well, now she has to know you now. You're a director. You're a film director.
Sure.
Yeah. Good grief.
So much has changed.
Good grief.
Yeah.
This is on Netflix.
Yeah.
You wrote this and directed this.
Yeah.
What inspired you for it?
Well, I lost my grandmother just at the end of the pandemic, and I feel like the pandemic was a tough time for so many of us, and so many people lost loved ones during that time. And I was trying to, like, make sense of grief, like what personal grief meant to me in the wake of, like, a collective grief. And, you know, you're asking yourself, are you doing it right? Am I feeling the things I should feel? Am I honoring the person in the way that I feel like I should? All of these questions that I've now come to realize are questions that a lot of us ask when we're going through the process of grief. And I thought, well, this could be a really interesting conversation to have in a movie. Yeah. And so I started to write, and I wanted to explore the idea of friendship taking front and center in a movie. I hadn't seen that in a long time. So I wanted to make a movie about friendship in the wake of grief. And,
good for you.
You know, here we are.
Yeah, here we are talking about it.
It's very lucky. Yeah.
I want to show everyone a clip. Here's Dan Levy in Good Grief. Take a look.
It's like an ache right here.
What is it?
Loss. It's like a little ulcer right here that never goes away. And you somehow figure out ways to take your mind off it enough to not feel it as much. But yeah, sometimes you lose sight of what's going on around you because you just want to be able to breathe the way you did before.
Yeah, come on, buddy, come on. Come on, pal.
It's a laugh riot.
That's good,
it's
though.
It's a gross-out comedy.
You're doing this. It's not a gross-out comedy. Congratulations. It's a big deal. You're awesome.
Thank you.
Dan Levy, everybody. Good Grief is streaming now on Netflix. We're doing something fun with Dan after the break. Stick around, everybody. Come on back. Hey, hey.